to semantic content models. Me, Andriy, Zhidko, Dragan, Nanic, and Vitaly Zelensky will present you content of the webinar. Today, we would like to focus on evolution of publishing models in Tridion, benefits that data publishing will bring to our customers. We will cover possibilities of content modeling on content manager side, as well as how you can define your semantic content models on dynamic experience delivery side. And at the end, we will show you a true use case for using new semantic content models feature. Let's first talk about evolution of publishing models in Tridion. So let's start from static publishing. That is not completely gone, but it's not something that you will see very often. Rendering, or in other words, generation of website content view is happening on Content Manager using templating. We are pushing pre-rendered HTML fragments to broker database, and then these fragments can be requested from web application using CIL. The next step of the evolution, our DXA dynamic publishing. When we do publish data model in DXA R2 JSON format to the broker database, but we are still using templates to convert XML to JSON data. And on dynamic experience delivery side, we do have public content API with DXA extension that consumes DXA R2 JSON from broker and produces semantic content models to web applications through public content API client. And the valid question is, why do we need templates to produce native data model from content manager to dynamic experience delivery? And the answer is new data publishing, where we do generate standard model on content manager side to put into the broker database. And you don't need do any templating for this. It can be controlled by editors, or you can call them content designers, and they can do it on the schema level. On dynamic experience delivery side, you can configure your semantic content models and expose them through GraphQL endpoint to the application, and the client is an optional thing here. So current publishing architecture with modular templating and dynamic experience delivery deployer was a powerful feature for its time being. It powered a lot of really cool implementations, but the world has moved on, and website development requires strong development tool support such as Git, Jenkins, Octopus Deploy, and so on. Modular templating that requires uploading code into Content Manager gets in the way of modern development approaches, not augmenting them. That is why SDL decided to focus Content Manager on content modeling, productivity tools for content creation and intelligent services, and dynamic experience delivery focuses more on content search, content retrieval, and mashups capabilities. That will separate and simplify content releases and web application development cycles. Data publishing will become the standard way of publish content from Content Manager to dynamic experience delivery. More to that, it will become the engine for the set of brand new features such as DXA 3.0, DXAJS, semantic content models, faceted taxonomy, and semantic search capabilities, and many more. Three main bullets you need to know about data publishing. First of all, it's enabler for semantic content models that we'll cover today, as well as it's enabler for Tridion site search. That is out-of-the-box search on content delivery site that will be covered in details on a separate webinar. Data publishing it's all about publishing content as structured data in JSON format next to existing rendered content, and we use this standard data model, so you don't need in data modification, so you do not need any data modifications and any custom template. Let's talk about how you can control your data model on content manager side. Per each field in schema, you will have two additional settings: include specific field to data model, and second one, provide ability to search for specific field. Both settings are applicable only for semantic content models feature. And you can publish field, but do not allow to search for it in case it's some metadata that will be used on application side. Or you can exclude this field from data model, and obviously without possibility to search for it, in case this field is required only on content manager side, for example, for event system or workflow. When you're defining a new field, both properties are set to true by default. Mentioned on previous slide, settings are applicable for following schemas. So it's component schema, including embeddable schema, metadata schema, multimedia schema, and region schema. Schema also has general setting to mark it as publishable or indexable, additionally to settings that are available per each field. In case this schema is used only as metadata schema and content should not be indexed, content should not be available for search on dynamic experience delivery side, you can uncheck setting related to indexing and all your schema fields won't be searchable. In case you do want to exclude item based on this schema from publishing completely, you can uncheck setting related to publishing. And these settings are applicable for component schema, for metadata schema, and for multimedia schema. During upgrade, new settings for corresponding schemas will be set to true. And after upgrade, we recommend to revise your schemas to remove or not index unnecessary schema or fields. Data publishing is also supported in your integrations through connector framework or external content library. Implementation of your connector defines if binary should be included or passed by reference. We are using and we respect this setting and in data publishing and either include binary into the package or pass it by reference. External metadata fields are always published and indexed for now. So in 9.5, you will not have control over it. We will always publish it and index. Most of you know that Tridion has a notion of static and dynamic components. Interesting part is that templates define whether component is static or dynamic. Component itself doesn't contain such property or setting. Since for data publishing you don't need templates at all, then all components as of 9.5 will become to be dynamic. You can call it like this is a beginning of the end for static publishing. It's valid to notice that templating and so templating, publishing and templating, resolving behavior didn't change. So customers that do not want to switch immediately to use data publishing can still use their templating implementations. In Tridion, we have page and component templates. For component templates, we already starting from 9.5 version allow to not specify template at all. For page template, for now, we decided to go with default empty data template. Since it's empty, then no templating rendering is involved, means we are safe from performance perspective. Although we are looking at possibilities to make page template nullable, to be nullable in 9.5 scope. The next capability that I would like to talk about is handling linked items in data publishing. Previously, Tridion didn't have out-of-the-box solution to handle generally linked items. There is one setting in advanced section of publishing dialog that allows you to publish one level deep linked item in case it was already published. DXA also has solution that sticks only certain DXA specific templates. Sticks only to certain DXA specific templates. With new setting, you will be able to expand linked items to a certain depth. Default value for it 0 means do not expand. -1 is infinitive expansion. And it's also valid to mention that new capability is available only for data publishing, since all linked components are resolved without a template. If expansion depth is specified, it will be applied for content and metadata fields, as well as links in rich text field. And it will be applied for following item types. So content, I already mentioned this. It will be applied for component, page, and structure groups. I would like to hand over to Dragan to talk about semantic content models.
Thank you, Andriy. So let me just share my screen. Let me know if you can see it.
Yes, I can see it.
Just a second. So, semantic content models. Let me just start with what that is. Right now, that gives the possibility for our customers to define their own semantic content model close to their domain and close to the web applications that they want to build or any other type of application. And we're using GraphQL schema definition language for it. So that would give the possibility to actually query and filter the familiar concepts. For example, adding something like posts, blogs, articles, news, whatever is relevant for the application at hand. You can see the example that we used for on the right of this page. So adding something like for posting and blogs. How we do this in dynamic experience delivery side. So we expose semantic content models natively in the content service API with GraphQL, and it gives a possibility to change or to refine and add either a custom root query or change something within the existing root queries for the items, component, and pages. So if you use the default content, then you can get something Then you get everything from the CM side, and you would use on untyped content and have to sort through the fields present there. Instead, you can define your own semantic data model and expose just the fields of interest. In order to do that, there has to be some configuration involved, of course, and semantic content models are defined in the file cd.graphqls in the directory content service /config/schemas, which can be done on premise by the customers or by partners. And the only thing to notice is that the service has to be restarted once you change something or add a new content model there. Of course, we will provide an add-on service extension for updating as well, for cloud clients and our own professional services. What is the actual content that you need to put in the cd.graphqls is will be specified in the documentation, and here is a short example of what you put within that file, so that you define the post and the post body, for example, and also the mappings between the fields coming from the content manager side. How does it work? It actually uses the GraphQL framework. So what you can see on this page, all the boxes in yellow are standard part of the GraphQL framework. So we fetch things from the broker through data layer and data loaders, and within the resolver we also connect it to the semantic content model definition and use the transformer there to map corresponding fields. So as you can see on the right, within the response now there is a proper content as specified within the data model configuration file. What does it mean in the actual response? So here is some simple comparison. If you use default schema, then the page as a root query will come with all the components within that, using exposing all the fields like IDs, titles, types and things. While you can actually, instead of going through that structure, have applied semantic content model configuration and get something nice as posts and just the corresponding title if that's an interest. This will save also, this will make it easier for developers to connect just to the corresponding data and to immediately link it to the proper part in the application. So how do you actually use it? You can use the GraphQL client of your own choosing. Here are some examples on the right. And for developers, any semantic content model that is configured will also be present in the GraphQL API documentation. So they can refer to the documentation and see which parameters are available, which fields are available, and use them directly in the API. So with this brief introduction, it is time to switch to demo.
Let's cover true use case for the demo. So let's imagine that I am a website developer. Yeah, as a website developer, I think that I am an expert in this area. I know some CSS, I know HTML, I know some JavaScript and some frameworks like Angular or React. I have a task. I need to develop a website using Tridion. Since I am a smart developer, I can understand what is schemas, components. I really love blueprinting. But when it comes to templating, Dreamweaver templates, DXA, transforming XML to JSON, what, why I need to know all these things. And with introducing data publishing, we can introduce you a new suggested way of developing a SDL Tridion website. What you need to do? You first of all you need to define your content structure using new schema settings. After that, you can already publish content as soon as you did define a structure of the data model, and you don't need to do any templating design at all. Next step is defining your semantic content models. That is actually optional, and you can use data model as it was generated by Content Manager and published to Dynamic Experience Delivery. After that, what you need is to consume content using public content API through the GraphQL endpoint. Let me switch to environment. So as we talked, first of all, what I need to do is to define content. So let's create a schema. Let's call it article schema. Let's define some fields. So I'd like to have heading. As was mentioned previously, you have two settings to be able to publish this field and be able to search it on the Dynamic Experience Delivery site. So I would like to have heading that should be searchable and of course publishable. I would like to have some short description. And full article. That both of them I would like to be searchable, indexable. So short article will be used to display basic information about this article, and full article body obviously for the full article page. And for metadata, I would like to have two fields. One will be used on website application site, so it's called like appear ad, that will be responsible to and that will be used on web application site to show my article page at specific time. So I don't want this field to be searchable because it's going to be used only by my application, so it's my metadata. And also I would like to define one field that will be used on content manager site only. For example, I would like to use it for workflow. So I would like to define at which date I would like to publish this article. So it should be date both. So we have defined some content schema. Let's create component based on it. I already created some really basic content, so just copy as you can see, I just created a schema, so I didn't specify any allowed component template, and previously you were not able to publish this component just because you need to meet business rules on content manager site and allow schema for a certain template. But with data publishing, it was already mentioned, it is template-less publishing, and I can already publish this component. So it was also mentioned that for page template, we are going to introduce data publishing, default data publishing page template. So here it is. So as you can see, it's empty. There is no templated building blocks, or there is, and as well as like a separate content. So it's really empty. So let's create some page. Let's use my data publishing page template and add some content here. I would like to probably add an image. As you can see, I don't have any allowed templates for it, and I can add this component to my page. As well as for my article component, I also can add it to the page, save it, and publish. So content was published to Dynamic Experience Delivery site, and I would like to hand over to Vitaly, who will talk about how content is processed and how content can be modeled to semantic content models on Dynamic Experience Delivery site.
Yeah. So from GraphQL perspective, we have, as Andriy said, two components, one binary, one common component with some content there, some text. And we developed some page, which is retrieving component and binary on it, and uses GraphQL and strong type model. From the beginning, I will show you how it's retrieved. This method, this query is defined in strong type model configuration. I fetch it, so it has three fields: heading, article body, and short description. I can manage it like this and fetch more or less data if I need for my website. And here is binary content URL, which is used for downloading that content. And I will show you how the page works. Here it is. Yep. And on click on the link, we are trying another part of text, which is full text. This one. Yeah, it's article body, shows on click show more. And before we clicked show more, it shows short description. So how we did it? Created a small page, which use GraphQL for driving data. And here's GraphQL configuration, which define several new methods. For example, we used web component method, which maps to the JSON structure and retrieves the heading, article, body for making it like more comfortable for my site. I removed it from article-body to article body and show description. This like a very simple example how standard type model configuration can be applied for user websites. I will show you a little bit more tricky example, not very tricky, but here I created one new extra method for retrieving titles fields from my component. Here I defined one new method, component titles, and here I defined some logic for it. So I'm searching through the through the content all the title fields and creating an array of them. It may be used like for some keywords on the page or something like that. Here is in general how it's seen. So we have the component with untyped contents. It can't be customized while it's not defined in strongly typed model. We have title in desk section and in main section, main title and demo title. And after defining my schema, I can retrieve it in such a way. So this allows to make lightweight queries for getting some dynamic data from current component or current page and so on. That's all from my side.
Thank you, Vitaly, and thank you everyone for watching our webinar related to semantic content modeling.